is a sniffs. She also told me Driss would be coming along to get your bike together. But I think he may have... I knew it. What? Hadn't meant to say that out loud. Hadn't meant to say that out loud. So I tell her I was just clearing my throat. I don't begrudge Driss his forgetfulness. Were I tasked with so many odds and ends, I might be just as scattered. And besides, this will be good for you. I want you to scavenge the hoverbike parts yourself. I'm gonna make my own hoverbike? I asked Sizu if I'm expected to make my own hoverbike. No, you are not going to make your hoverbike, you are going to build your own hoverbike. What's the difference? To make suggest you are creating something, but your bike already exists. Exists. They simply haven't taken form yet. Here, take this. The navigator. Scissor hands me something. This is a navigator. You can use it to mark waypoints on your compass. It should be useful in finding the odd parts. I asked Scissor where I might start looking. I keep thinking Scissor sounds like Scissor. You know the musician? Our bikes are reborn in the ruined ships, in fragments spread apart. A good start would be the ship down there near the camp. You'll find another up on that great rock, near the other side of the canyon. And another behind the old dam on the hill. Use your navigator to mark that down if you need. You'll need to gather a control panel, a power supply, and a calibrator. I'll be back before you know it. I tell Sizzle I'll see you soon and head off in search of the components. Together we'll create something new out of the old. Alright. Is that it? It won't let me move unless I do the navigator bit. I don't like the marker there. Okay, I have that there. RB. What the hell's that? Okay. I'm gonna glide. No, can I get further up? Maybe I need to get further up to get there. Yeah, it's fine. Don't worry about it. Ilaria. The balloon was more fun than the person in it. I approached the cartographer. Cartographer Jordan. Ah, greetings, child. I saw you looking longingly at my great balloon. Quite a piece of work, isn't she? It's bigger than I thought. I tried to explain that when I first saw the balloon, I thought it was very small and somewhat far away. But now I see it's quite large and was very far away. I fumble through the explanation though, and the cartographer just nods without saying anything. I nod back. Well, good to meet you. And, oh, I should introduce myself. I'm Jordan. I tell him I'm Sable. Suppose if you've come all this way to see me, it's probably a map you're after, eh, Sable? I would love a map. I tell the cartographer I'd love a map. Of course she would. That will be 50 cuts. To my ears, it's a fair price for a map, but too expensive for a pre-gliding glider with empty pockets. I tell Jordan I'll be back. I'll need to ask Jaddy for some money. Farewell, child. Alright. Ooh, can I get up there? Oh. Can I get up there? Oop. That could have been disastrous. The answer is no. Doesn't seem to be. I want to be a carnogrammer too. That's hella tight. Follow your dreams. Oh! Oh! I almost dropped on the crow then. And who are you? As she looks out across the landscape, Zeki's shoulders sag a little. I wonder what she's thinking about. Something on your mind? Zeki's voice is weakly incredulous. I don't know how she's done it. That's Ilaria over there. I follow her gaze to a little speck in the distance, which I now understand is her daughter, Ilaria. Does she need help? Zeki shakes her head. No, she's fine, and I'll get her. She shrugs. Parenting. I suppose I'll know more about that when I'm older. It's being naughty for her mummy. There's a lot of crows around here. I wonder if I can catch them. I tell Jaddy that the cartographer wants 50 cuts for a map of the Iwa. I try to hedge the way I speak about this, as I'm not entirely sure whether that's too much, not enough, or precisely its value. She tells me not to worry. Here's some money to get you going on your journey. Use it mostly wisely, and then a little unwisely when the mood strikes. It's good to know the value of money, but you never want to be ruled by it. I thank Jaddy effusively, and I'm on my way. Sick. So let's just head up here. Okay, and then hoi. When I go gliding, I'm going to be a climber. I know what that means. Greetings, child. I'll buy that map. Perfect, let's trade then. A map of the Ewer sold by members of the Cartography Guild. How many would I like to buy? Just the one. Ah, it seems I have nothing left for you. Oh, he only had one. Okay. I thank Jordan for the Ewer map and all its vast possibilities. Something about this makes it feel more real. Good luck on your guiding, Sable. I still remember mine. I ask how it was. Short. I knew since I was a boy that cartography was for me, but I spent a little extra time out there, just to enjoy the world. Speaking of, keep an eye on the skies, eh? Plenty of my colleagues out there, and they'll have more maps to sell you. From Hakoa to the Sodic Waste. I thank Jordan for the chip and say goodbye. Farewell, child. Quest completed. That's three quests completed. Alright. Sizzo. Okay, I think the task is talking about, oh, maybe not. Alright, let's see if I'm. Okay. These two things are related. Sizzle, what you got for me? What a pleasant way to spend a Sunday. Boom. Thanks, Daddy. So let's go get one of the parts then. There's nothing of use to be found in the ship, but I noticed a blinking light flashing on the dash pit of the cockpit. Push the button. A voice crackles from the machinery in front of me. It sounds like recording, it's barely audible. Stop messing about with those buttons, you absolute idiot. Sorry, Raven. It's a trait. I don't think I have to remind you how much work it was to get this far. Almost there. Right, let's see if what that old machine has told us holds up. If not, there will be hell to pay. I hear the sounds of mechanical adjustments being made. Three clicks, buttons being pressed, perhaps? Okay, when I push this orange thing, pull that lever hard. Yes, Ramon. Sound of a click and grunt before a snapping sound. Oh, on Rohana's mask. Oh, on Rohana's mask. Not that hard. You've torn it out. Suddenly, the speakers are filled with static and a low rumble that gradually increases in pitch. And then the sounds of someone cheering. It worked, we're flying. More cheering! Is that the sound of someone dancing? Okay, let's focus. This thing is moving fast, we need to slow it down a bit. How do we do that, Ramon? Let me check the machinist's notes. A long pause, the rumbling static sound that started playing when the ship took off is still increasing in pitch. Oh fuck. Ramon? That lever, Toma, the one you just ripped out. We're going too fast, we're going to crash. We need to try to... The recording cuts off there. Dumbasses. You silly idiots. So. Oh, is it because I haven't made it my active quest? Most likely. This. Oh! Saima, are you looking for a calibrator? I am immediately on guard. Saima has always been a mischief maker, and taken tremendous pleasure in tormenting me. In theory, I'm older, more experienced, and should be more than able to withstand it. In practice... You won't find it here. I've hidden it. You'll never find it. Never, never. She never fails to get to me. May I have it? I decide to be gentle, and I ask her, may I please have it? May I please have it? She, okay. May I please have it? She mimics me terribly, all high and screechy. Despite my best efforts, I seethe. Oh well, too bad. Maybe you'll find it on your own. But I don't think so. Uh-oh. Simon laughs off my irritation, but I'm not going to give her the satisfaction. I cross my arms and I try to effect a change. I'll give you the calibrator. I put out my hand, proud of myself for standing tall before Simon. If you give me some beetles. That's a fair trade, isn't it? Something you want for something I want. I try to decide if it's more mature to push her over and steal the calibrator or to acquiesce. But then I simply stifle a sigh and shake her little hand. Perhaps some of the adults in the camp know where I can find some. So now I've got to find bugs, huh? Anyway. Well, it was nice knowing you, Simon. No, can't run you over. Yeah, it's probably easier for me just to get off the bike. Ibexi red dye. A dye bottle for the colors of the Ibexi red bike. Ooh. Nice. My bike's gonna be red. What's this? Is that where she hit it? Hmm. Simon. Okay, well, found one cool thing. Okay, we need to get to the village. Come on now. Jaddy. I could ask about catching beetles for that awful little Simer. Do you know where I can find some beetles? There's a nest of beetles just east of here. You can't walk up to one and catch it though. You can't just walk up to one and catch it though. There's some seeds growing on the rocks around the nest. Drop a seed on the floor and the beetle will start eating it. Then you can sneak up and grab it. I glitched into that. Like, it immediately, like, dumped me into her default text. I don't know what that was about. So let's change it to, yeah, beetle detour. Sure, sure, sure. Yet. Oh, there it is. Nice. Hey, so... this direction here. Oh boy. Is it up here? Hmm. Must be. Bugs in here? No. Are these the seeds that they're talking about? No. I am confusion. Oh, they'll see something then. There we are. Okay. He doesn't want to be caught, sure. Do I need these things? I think so. Get shrekt! Achievement unlocked. Got your nose. Haha, got your nose. Catch all of them. Damn it. Wow, you're finally playing this game. Indeed. Indeed I am, life. I love the art style of this, yeah. I've been meaning to get to this one for quite a while now. Yeah. Let me give you a cheers. There we go. Nice. There we go. You are appreciated and valued. Right, so we've just started out. It gives me Breath of the Wild vibes, even though I've never played Breath of the Wild, and it's likely I never will. Oh, oh, you mind? What's this? Nice. Look at a yellow one. I'm hoping they have some epic world building planned out. I think it looks like I'm like at the very beginning. I think it looks sufficiently detailed. I'm just hoping that I can overcome what I perceive to be some of the jank bits. Okay. Excellent at escaping would-be predators, yellow elephant beetle's distinct fondness for tassel seeds is surprisingly effective at distracting them enough for capture. Indeed. As I've just proven. Yoink. I'm going to need to catch up with you at some point for a Discord or live. Or some pretty big life updates. A life update from life. Okay. Perhaps after the stream ends. Okay, dude. Oh, but not today. Today I just want to watch you play this game. I see. Okay. Hehe. Got you, bitch. And now that I've completely decimated the beetle population. Oh wait, there's two over there. I think that's all the beetles, quite literally. I didn't even give them the seed to eat, I just like yeeted them. Wait, is that the music or is that like a pitter patter of a beetle? Nah, I think we're good. I now have a, what, 9 or so? And I reckon... I reckon she's gonna steal the other parts of my hover bike and she'll demand more beetles, but I've already, like, got them, so... Nice. What is... Oh, that's my bike. There we go. Alright, time to go back to that girl, I believe. Oh, actually, we're closer to here. We could just go straight here. And I think I will. Get there. Get there. Hey. Control panel is definitely here. I've already done that. Do I need to go into the ship? Whoa. Yeah, the other side there. Yeah, okay. So can I just kind of float over? It should be sufficient. There we go. Now inside here I believe it could be. Must also be something here. Nothing? Gypped. Alright, where we go here? Oh, okay. Atori. This way, yeah, sure. Wait, which is gonna be easiest? Yeah, climbing up this wall bit.